So we've just completed a Stewart Copeland DVD where we've taken five classic police tracks, which I'm sure everyone's familiar with, drummers or not, and so we've analysed the parts that Stewart plays, broken them down so that you can really put the microscope to those drum tracks and play along with the tracks accurately so you'll know the parts exactly. Stewart's a very musical player, and I think he's got quite a wide range of influences. He talks about his time in the Middle East where he grew up, and also you can hear, so there's that sort of ethnic percussive approach to playing, and then you hear something like his Steve Gadd influence in there as well. And I think it's all those different influences that makes him such an original drummer, really. So in terms of techniques, we're looking at a variety of ways of approaching these reggae-type grooves, and you'll find in the techniques section a variety of exercises for coming up with different ways of playing that, placing the cross stick with the different syncopated placements that Stewart uses, the dotted syncopated rhythms and triplet feels. And so as well as those generic exercises, we also analyse the parts that Stewart plays on the track. So you get to hear them in isolation and slowed down, and then as a performance along with the track. I'd certainly say there's something for everyone here. It's obviously some tracks require less from you technically, but there are certain parts of the tracks that really are quite technically demanding. Again, some of those cross-rhythmic ideas with the cross stick, that kind of thing, they're really quite tricky. And there are various parts, as you'll see on the DVD, that can be quite demanding, but there's other parts of the tracks, other grooves and things that you'll just be able to play along with the original once you've learned them. I think my favourite track has to be Message in a Bottle. I think the drum part covers so many different feels. You've got the double time, sort of Motown type feel on the intro, and then the various reggae feels that appear throughout the track then, with the toms playing this mambo-esque type pattern. He manages to get so many different drum parts into this one track, but all coming from a musical perspective. Great drumming. I think in terms of tips, what you can take away from this DVD is you can really see how the drums can work really musically within a track. I think by learning and familiarising yourself with the way Stewart approaches these tracks is going to give you a really good understanding of how musical you can be as a drummer within a piece of music.